Hello, everybody. It's time to ask me stuff, because questions. Yeah. Two questions. Can you do a review of Under the Dome? And do you read your questions to yourself before you read them on video? Under the Dome, I liked a lot. Like, I loved it. Except for the end, I thought the ending was kind of crappy. And I skim through the questions, and I get an email every time somebody posts a comment on my video, so I see every comment on all of my videos. So I see them when they're getting posted. Since you love Harry Potter, what is your favorite kind of fantasy, such as medieval fantasy, Lord of the Rings, Game of Thrones, or future science fantasy, Ender's Game, Mass Effect? I like fantasy that's relatable to the real world, meaning like it takes place in our world, maybe just a little bit different. So probably more future in that case. What was the most depressing book you ever read, and what was the most life-changing book? Depressing is like, that's really bad, I don't want to be reading this depressed. I'd have to go with The Scarlet Letter. That still stands out in my mind as the absolute worst book I've ever read. And I had to read it for school. So usually when a book's that bad, I quit. That's why it stands out, because I actually had to read it all the way through. So I'll go with that as depressing. If you just want like, ain't nothing good about this book, like a nihilist book, probably 1984. That was really nihilist, and I don't really like the ending because of it. I'm torn on that book. I love it and I hate it. Most life-changing book I ever read? I don't know. I don't think I've ever had my life changed by a book. Stephen King's On Writing helped me a lot professionally, so I'll go with that one. Did you own any video game consoles as a kid? I owned a Sega Genesis as a wee little kid. It was actually my parents, and they let me play it when they didn't know that I was playing it. And then I had a PS1 when I was in elementary school, the original PlayStation. That and the Dreamcast were the first ones with CDs. That's why I wanted the PlayStation, because I had a CD. I thought that was cool. Did you ever stop reading a book because you hated where the story was going? I don't know specifically for that. Sometimes I felt like it wasn't going anywhere, so I quit. But yeah, I stop reading books all the time. I admit to this. If I don't like a book and it's boring me, I'll stop reading it. There's too many good books out there for me to waste my time on a bad book. Tell us something embarrassing about yourself. I can jump, but only when I'm in the mood. Hi, Travis, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm on the part of my story when the main character learns about what she's having from another main character and I'm having trouble doing it. Somehow I can't find the right way to telling the backstory without giving too much info or too little. How should I go about it? Best way to do backstory is usually flashbacks. Sometimes you just tell. That's the stop showing and tell, which is like opposite of what you're supposed to be doing. But backstory telling works fine, so you can do that. You mentioned in a video a while ago that you read Harry Potter yearly or so. If you could choose one book from the series that the characters had that we don't, which would it be? Books like Hogwarts, A History, and the spell books are examples of what I'm talking about. I would want a history book, I guess, obviously, because the spell books and potion books wouldn't work, because I'm a muggle. Unless they did work, in which case I'd want a spell book or a potion book. Oh, I didn't really like The Body. Why? Because the short story thrown in there. But I love Misery. Confession. I skipped over the book within a book in Misery. I read a little bit of it. I was like, this is stupid. So every time that showed up in the book, I would skip it. I loved all of Misery. I didn't read that book thing in there because it had bees and it was weird. Why'd you stop making how to write a novel videos? And you mentioned you are a history buff. What are your most researched topics? I still do Writing Wednesday videos when I do videos. If you're talking about like the crappy videos that I first started doing it, because they're crappy and I have higher standards now, I guess. And I'm most interested in classical history, so Greco-Roman classical, that classical. I'm 13 and I struggle with writing stories all the time. Ideas come to me, whether I'm watching TV or taking a walk. I have about 50 ideas, which according to my family are really good. Every time I get halfway through a story, I notice that my story is going off track. Oh, let's see where you're going with this. I could turn from a comedy into a horror in the space of 30 pages. Do you have any advice on how to control this problem? You should let stories do what they're going to do naturally. That's the best advice I have. If you try to force it to be something it's not, it's going to feel like it's forced to be something it's not. If you have a bunch of ideas, pick the best one and stick with it through the end. Don't get halfway through it and say, oh, I got this other really great idea and do that, because then you never finish anything. And the first step to finishing a book is finishing it. Hey, Travis, I'm writing a book and I've got a really good idea of it. Well, in my mind at least, in my head. And I'm not planning to get my pen and paper and write down a thorough plan outlining every key factor in the plot. I was wondering, does writing a well-detailed plan help in the long term? And if you don't mind me asking, do you do it and does it help you? Thanks. It all depends on you. Figure out what works for you. When I first started writing, I had to have a pre-write because I would get distracted and everything. But after I wrote a couple novels, I learned how they basically go along. You have a better grasp of it in your head. Some people love pre-writes. They'll always do them. They'll do extremely thorough pre-writes. Some people don't use pre-writes. It's up to you. Figure out what works for you. If something's not working, try something else. Once you find something that works, that's what works. Have you read The Hobbit? I have read The Hobbit, and actually, I like The Hobbit quite a bit. I've read it 3 or 4 times, which is fine because I don't like the Lord of the Rings trilogy. I think it's mostly because The Hobbit, the epic language, which is kind of the crazy over-the-top way that Tolkien writes the trilogy, I don't think it was real strong in The Hobbit. There wasn't a lot of epic language, and I don't like epic language, as you can tell by my reviews. I like things that are straightforward and tells a story. I read books for the story, not for the writing. And I know people that like epic language, and that's fine. That's a personal thing. I just don't like it. So that's the main reason I don't like The Lord of the Rings. Well, that was all the questions. You know what to do down there. Ask them, I answer them next month. Until then.